In this video, we'll be taking a look at the MaxTension tangent terminal system. This is a MASH compliance system designed to be installed with the 31-inch midway splice guardrail system. The manufacturer's installation manual includes an installation checklist. If possible, try to have that checklist in front of you as we go through this video. We'll be taking a look at some of the important items on the checklist. So the first thing to look at is the cable closest to the traffic side. Make sure that cable feeds up through the impact head, through the lower opening of the impact head. The cable away from traffic is going to feed through the top. Each cable has a sleeve. Make sure these sleeves are on the impact head end of this cable and not on the far end. Make sure that post number one has no blockout. You'll notice that all of the other posts do have the blockouts. Post number one should not. The slots on post number one where the rail is attached to the post on the impact head side. That's a critical piece. Make sure that there's a square washer on the back side. And you'll notice that on the front side, there is a rectangular washer. You'll also notice that the guardrail nuts should be on the traffic side or on the front side of the rail so that they don't interfere with the cable on the back. This rectangular piece here is called the friction plate. Make sure there's a friction plate inserted down into the opening of the top of the impact head. This gets inserted perpendicular to the rail and then it's turned to be fully engaged so that it's in line with the rail. The cables pass through this plate and they get crimped as the plate is engaged. Make sure that the bolts that hold it in place are tight. There's two on the front and two on the back. Moving on to the splice between rail number one and rail number two. Make sure that the guardrail nuts again are on the traffic side or on the front face so that they don't interfere with the cable. This assembly is called a slider joint. The slider joint is made up of three pieces. It has a front side, an inner side, and a back plate. Make sure that the front piece is attached to the downstream side of rail number two at these locations. The inner section should be attached to the upstream side of rail number three. And you'll see those are bolted on the inside. At that location, in that location. The back plate is attached directly to the front plate. Make sure that the nuts are on the back side away from traffic. Also make note that the little triangular shaped cutouts in the front and the back plates, make sure those line up and make sure that those are pointed toward the impact head. That's how you'll know that this assembly is in the correct direction. There should also be a sawtooth that should be fully engaged inside the opening of the back plate. Also make note of the cables. The cables should be taut with no visible sagging. A couple final things to note. This is a tangent system, but it can be installed at an offset of up to 2 feet back away from the normal face of rail. Make note also that this is a 31-inch system. The height is measured from the finished grade to the very top of the rail. And there is a 1-inch tolerance, plus or minus. Final thing to note would be the lapping. The lapping is very critical with this system. Rail number one should always be lapped over rail number two, which is lapped over rail number three, which is lapped over rail number four. This is especially important on a trailing end. On a trailing end, the lapping needs to be in the opposite direction from our normal MaineDOT convention. That completes the checklist for the MaxTension tangent terminal system. Make note that in the field, there would be a reflective end attached to this impact head. Please refer to the installation manual for more details and make sure that you fully understand this system before you attempt to install it or inspect it. Thanks for watching.